Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is my first time ever filming and making a makeup tutorial, so I'm super excited to share it with you guys. Hope you all enjoy it. Let's get started. Since the eyebrows are the center focus of the face, I like to start with them first. For her eyebrows, I'm using Anastasia Dipbrow Pomade in Dark Brown. She has full eyebrows already, so I'm just going to fill them in and give them a little shape. After I'm done filling them in, I like to carve them out using Tarte's Creaseless Concealer. A little goes a long way. I like to carve them out before the foundation, or else they'll look too highlighted and it wouldn't look natural. As you can see, I didn't have anything left over on the brush, so you just use that extra concealer left over for the top of the brow. I'm using Sigma's 3D Angle Concealer Brush to apply MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot as an eyeshadow base. Make sure to blend the edges because it dries super quick and kind of thickens. For this look, I'm going to use the Lorac Unzipped Gold Palette. I'm going to start off highlighting the brow bone with Undressed. You could use any bone or cream color to highlight under the brow. Now I'm going in with my transition shade right underneath the brow bone. You can use any neutral color for the transition shade. This helps with blending and will even soften the look. Now I'm going in with Unwind right on her crease underneath the transition shade. After applying it in her crease, you're just going to want to blend and blend and blend. And when you think you're done blending, blend some more. Can't stay in one place. Keep moving like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. Like a bullet train. Before applying the lid shade, I sprayed my brush with Fix Plus just to give the eyeshadow extra hold. I'm using Unpredictable from the Unzipped Gold Palette, and it is just so beautiful. It doesn't read on camera like how it does in person, but it's the perfect rose gold. After applying the lip color, I'm just going back in with Unwind and blending it some more. Now that the eyeshadow is done, I'm going to apply a little bit of eyeliner. When applying eyeliner, you want to get as close as you can to the lash line so no skin shows through between the lashes. The eyeliner I'm using is Inglot Gel Liner in 77, and it is hands down the best eyeliner I've ever tried, and it's so cheap as in the price, but it's amazing. Stays on all day, it's waterproof, doesn't smudge. It's seriously amazing. Also, I'm sorry for my big hands being in the way. This is my first time filming, so I'll watch out next time. I'm sorry, guys. When applying lashes, make sure the glue is super tacky. In this case, less is more. Also, when they're drying on the client's eyes, make sure you're pressing them upwards and not downwards, because if they're downwards, they're just going to make your client's eyes look really droopy. And I'm so sorry for my big hands being in the way right now. I definitely learned from this. Sorry, guys. After the eyelashes are done, I like to grab black eyeshadow and just go over the eyeliner and glue just to blend everything out. Now that the eyes are pretty much done, it's time to start on the face. Hydrating and moisturizing is key to a flawless finished face. After applying the moisturizer, I like to get a dab beauty blender and just press the moisturizer into the skin. I do the same routine for the primer as I did for the moisturizer. As the moisturizer and primer are setting to the skin, I'm going to apply mascara. Now that I finished prepping your skin, I'm going to apply Nars Luminous Weightless Foundation in Barcelona. I lay the foundation on her face with a brush, and then I go in with a damp beauty blender in stippling motion. Whenever applying product on your skin, you always want to stipple and never swipe. Stippling, you're pressing it into your skin. Swiping, you're just swiping it off your face. So just keep that in mind. Now that our foundation is nice and even and flawless, it's time for the concealer. I'm using Tarte's Creaseless Concealer, and it is one of the best concealers I've ever used before. It doesn't crease, and a little goes such a long way. It's really, really great. I recommend this to everyone. Now we're just going to stipple and blend it out till the foundation and concealer blend with each other. To set the under eye concealer, I'm going to apply Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. Sorry for such a short clip, my camera died during the baking process. I'm just dusting off the extra translucent powder that's on her face. Also, when using the Lorac Unzipped Gold Palette, be careful when you're applying eyeshadow because there's tons of fallout and they're very flaky, so you might create a huge mess, so just be careful. I tried cleaning off the fallout with a brush, but it just didn't work, so I have to go in with my concealer. Thank you. I'm going to apply Max Shroom in the corner of her eyes to make her eyes pop. I'm using Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Palette to warm up her face, and I'm going a little bit heavy because it's a full glam look. She already has a beautiful nose, but I just wanted to define it a little bit more. I applied Benefits High Beam at the tip of her nose just to give it a little lift. I'm going in with Nars Orgasm Blush just on the apples of her cheeks. I'm applying MacDaddy's Diamond Powder and Conceited to give that extra glow. Adding MacDaddy's Diamond Powder in Illuminati to give her that extra highlight. I'm topping off this look with ColourPop's Lippie Stick in Pitch. Last but not least, I'm going to spray her face with Max Fix Plus to complete the whole look. So this is the final look. I hope you guys love it. I want to give a huge thanks to my cousin Rosie for being my gorgeous model. And for everyone who watched my first makeup tutorial, thank you so much. I hope I was helpful. Please thumbs up and subscribe. And remember, you are all fearfully and wonderfully made.